Hi everyone! Today I want to show you a simple but important experiment that explains why grounding your power supply correctly is essential, especially in CNC electronics and DIY projects. Here I have a 24-volt power supply on the table. It powers some motor drivers and a voltmeter. As you can see, when I measure across plus and minus, the voltmeter shows 24 volts. Everything looks good, right? Now let's check something interesting. I take the ground wire, this yellow-green wire here, which is connected to the earth ground of my AC plug, and I measure the voltage between ground and minus of the power supply. We get a voltage spike. That's strange, because minus is supposed to be the negative side of the 24 volts, but it's not connected to ground. It's floating. Let's try between ground and plus. Again, we get another voltage spike. So what's going on here? The reason is that this power supply is floating. Its output is not referenced to anything, not to chassis, not to earth ground. That means plus and minus just float at whatever potential the internet circuitry allows. Now, here's where the danger comes in. I have a USB cable here that connects a controller to my computer. Let me measure the resistance between the USB shield and the ground of the power supply. Beep! That means the USB shield is connected to the computer's ground, which is also the same ground as the AC plug. So imagine this. My power supply is floating, and now I connected a USB device, like a CNC controller, whose ground is tied to the computer. Suddenly, those floating voltages, or spikes, try to find a path to ground, through the USB cable. See voltage spikes. This can cause high inrush current or voltage surges directly into the USB circuitry. That's how USB port and controller boards get damaged. So how do we fix this? Simple. We connect the ground wire to the minus terminal of the power supply. Just like this. A jumper wire from earth ground to minus. Now, when I measure again between ground and minus, there's no voltage difference. Same for plus. The power supply is now referenced to ground. It's no longer floating. So the takeaway is, if you're using a power supply with USB devices or connecting to a computer, you must make sure the power supply has a solid reference to earth ground, usually by connecting minus to ground. This small wire can save your USB ports, your controller boards, and hours of frustration. Hope this helps someone avoid an expensive mistake. If you found this useful, hit like and feel free to ask questions in the comments. Thanks for watching!